Hi, my name is Chris Howell and I manage the software development team of SMS Pro, a web-based aviation SMS toolkit. In the last section, we quickly reviewed the dashboard and started looking at the issue reporting module. We'll continue looking at the issue reporting module and follow the reported issue into the issue manager. As we stated, users can report issues for other divisions, such as when they are visiting. There are four basic types of reports that users can submit: safety, security, quality, and compliance. Companies can either use our default report types, which are based on NASA's ASRS, or we can create custom report types. After reports are submitted, users get an email immediately thanking them for submitting their issue, and there is a link in that email that will drive them into the issue manager so they can see what's going on. The safety manager is also notified via email, also with a link of the reported issue that will take him directly into issue manager. I didn't want to take you into the details tab first, and that's where the safety manager would go when he clicked a link in his email. But we're just going to look at the first page of the issue manager. And we can see in the far right column that managers can quickly see the status and risk level of all issues. They can also see which issues have exceeded the targeted closure date, which is noted by this a little alert bell in the far right column. They can search for issues using the filters provided in the grid. They can filter these issues by division or by department. See the tabs at the top? After you select an issue, you can step through the issue and look at the details, assess the risk, classify the issue, manage the issue, this corrective actions, manage the costs, add attachments or manage the attachments, or conduct investigations. The risk assessment starts with a risk statement. If you need help with items or are uncertain as to certain SMS terms, there is considerable help available in SMS Pro. There is the mouse over help, there's visible notes available in many sections, such as what's displayed with the preparing a risk statement. There's also an online video library that has the most popular modules covered. There's also the customizable risk matrix that allows you to change colors, the dimensions of the risk matrix, and the words that appear when you mouse over the cells. And the words will usually appear in this gray box right to the right of the risk matrix. This is a continuation of the risk assessment. While assessing the risk, safety managers can send the report to designated agencies. This is an optional task. There are some report types that are required to be sent to external agencies. This functionality facilitates this requirement. The manager should also set the targeted closure date based on the corporate policy and, of course, the risk level. Safety managers can also recommend corrective actions. If they are also wearing the department head's hat, they can also assign the corrective action and the due date to other people. While others can recommend corrective actions, only the department heads have the authority to assign resources to them. Further down on this page, that's not shown here, auditors can leave comments on how this issue is managed. They can report findings or concerns relating to this particular issue. One can also see the audit history and the review history.